Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Babita. I am a practicing cataract surgeon, and in this video, I will be answering some of your most commonly asked questions on cataract. So the first most obvious question would be, what is cataract? So if this is our eye, this here is the natural lens which is present inside our eye. This lens is a transparent structure, and when light enters our eye, this lens plays an important role in focusing the light rays on our retina, and this is how we are able to see things. Now, when this lens loses its transparency, these light rays will not be able to reach the retina and our vision will be affected. This loss of transparency of the lens, or we can say this development of lens opacification, is known as cataract. At what age is cataract usually seen? So the most common type of cataract that is seen is the age-related cataract, which usually develops after 45 to 50 years of age. It is also known as senile cataract. So as the name suggests, this type of cataract develops as part of the aging process, which means that as we grow older, our lens loses its ability to maintain its transparency and cataract formation occurs. Is cataract seen in youngsters also? Yes, cataract can occur at any age. Although the most common type of cataract that we see is the age-related cataract, but cataract can also be present in newborn babies, in teenagers, in young adults. It can occur due to a genetic syndrome, or it can occur after some injury to the eye. It is also seen in people who suffer from diabetes or those who wear thick myopic glasses. Cataract can also occur in people who use steroid medications like steroid tablets, steroid inhalers, steroid injections, steroid creams for a long time. So all in all, the causes of cataract are many, and it is important to understand that cataract is not exclusively a disease of the elderly. It can occur at any age due to many different reasons. What are the symptoms of cataract? The most common symptom of cataract is blurring of vision. Your vision can be blurred for distance, or it can be blurred for near, or it can be blurred for both distance as well as for near. The patients typically complain of a cloudy or a foggy vision. Another symptom that is commonly experienced by cataract patients is glare. Glare is intolerance to bright light, like you have difficulty looking at the sun or you have difficulty looking at some oncoming vehicles. Driving at night becomes a challenge. Some people also complain of seeing rainbow-colored rings around light. These are known as colored halos, and they are experienced by patients who have cataract. Also, it is important to know that cataract does not cause any pain, any redness, or any watering from the eye. Can cataract occur in both eyes at the same time? Yes, age-related cataracts can develop in one eye or in both the eyes together. Though when the cataract is present in both eyes, it can sometimes be asymmetric, which means that one eye has a more advanced grade of cataract while the other eye may have an early cataract. How is a cataract detected? So most cataracts can be detected easily on torch light examination, but for complete evaluation of your cataract, your doctor will perform what we call a dilated eye examination. In dilated eye examination, some drops are put in your eyes which will expand your pupil, and this will help your doctor in performing a thorough and complete assessment of your eye condition. This entire process usually takes about 30 to 45 minutes. My doctor says that there is no evidence of cataract in my eyes right now. How often should I get my eyes checked? So for cataract evaluation, you should get your eyes checked once in a year. My doctor says that my cataract is early and not ready for surgery yet. When should I get my eyes checked again? So in cases of early cataract, we recommend an eye checkup every 3 months to look for progression of cataract. Should I wait for my cataract to mature before going for cataract surgery? No. Nowadays, we don't wait for cataract to mature before taking the patient up for cataract surgery. Mature cataract is an advanced stage of cataract when the entire lens becomes opaque and the patient is not able to see at all. Immature cataract is when some layers of the lens have turned opaque while some layers are still transparent. The reason why we prefer to operate when the cataract is immature is because the chances of surgical complications occurring are far less in an immature cataract than in a mature cataract. Also, the vision recovery is faster and patient comfort is more in surgeries done on immature cataracts. So I would not advise you to wait for your cataract to mature. If you are suspecting an eye problem, please consult your ophthalmologist immediately. So how would I come to know if my cataract is ready for surgery or not? You have to pay attention to your symptoms. The most important reason for undergoing cataract surgery is when your symptoms start interfering with your daily activities. For example, you have difficulty in recognizing faces, or you have difficulty while crossing the road, or you cannot read signboards, or you experience glare while driving. All of these are enough reasons for you to consult a cataract surgeon and get your eyes checked. What is a brown cataract? What is a black cataract? And what is a white cataract? So brown cataract, black cataract, white cataract, these are all advanced stages of cataract. When all the layers of the lens turn opaque, the lens turns white in color, and that is why we call it a white cataract. Sometimes it also happens that in advanced stages of cataract, some pigmentary changes occur in the lens and the lens turns brown or black in color. That is why brown cataract and black cataract. Is glaucoma the same as black cataract? No, glaucoma is not the same as black cataract. In fact, this is a very common misconception because glaucoma is called kala motiya and cataract is called safed motiya. And people translate the words kala motiya to black cataract. This is wrong. Glaucoma and cataract are two entirely different eye conditions and their treatments are also vastly different. Loosely speaking, glaucoma is when the pressure inside your eye increases and it damages the nerve of your eye. It has got nothing to do with lens opacification. In fact, I personally discourage using the term kala motiya for glaucoma. In my opinion, we should use the term glaucoma in both Hindi and English and reserve the word motiya bin for cataracts only. Are there any eye drops available to dissolve my cataract? No, at present there are no eye drops that can cure your cataract. Can I do anything to stop my cataract from progressing further? No, unfortunately nothing can be done to stop the progression of cataract, but to keep your eyes healthy in general, it is advised to eat a diet which is rich in antioxidants, to avoid overexposure to the sun, to refrain from bad habits like smoking, and to keep your blood sugar levels under check. What is the treatment of cataract? The only treatment of cataract is cataract surgery. In cataract surgery, we remove your natural lens that has turned opaque and we replace it with an artificial lens. My doctor said that I have cataract in both my eyes. Can I get both eyes operated together on the same day? No, both eyes of the patient are never operated on the same day. Ideally, we should keep a gap of 4 weeks between the first eye surgery and the second eye surgery. Though in most cases, if your first eye is recovering well, we do operate the second eye within 2 to 3 weeks also. What is an IOL? So IOL is short for intraocular lens. Intra means inside, ocular means eye. So IOL refers to a lens that is placed inside the eye. So it is the artificial lens that is implanted in your eye after your natural lens is removed during cataract surgery. Is it absolutely necessary for me to get an artificial lens implanted in my eye during cataract surgery? So as we learned in the beginning of this video, our lens helps in focusing the light rays on the retina of the eye, and this is how we are able to see. Now if we remove this lens, we need to replace it with something that would do the same job. That is focusing the light rays on the retina, and that is why we put an artificial lens to replace the natural lens to do that job. Can I feel the artificial lens inside my eye? Is it heavy? Does it hurt? So the artificial lens that is put inside your eye. It is not like a contact lens that is put on the surface of your eye. And the part of the eye where the artificial lens is implanted it does not have any nerves, so you cannot feel the lens inside your eye. It does not cause any pain or discomfort at all. Will I need to wear spectacles after cataract surgery? Now, whether you will need to wear spectacles after cataract surgery or not depends on the type of lens that is implanted in your eye. The most commonly implanted lenses are known as monofocal lenses. They give good vision for far, but for near work like reading or stitching, you will need to wear glasses. Though nowadays, special lenses like multifocal lenses, trifocal lenses and eyedrop lenses, which are extended depth of focus lenses, are available and they provide good vision for far, for near as well as for intermediate distance. However, these lenses are expensive and they may not even be suitable for you. Therefore, it is important to discuss with your eye surgeon before cataract surgery about the best lens that would be best suited for you. Can cataract form again in my eye after I have already undergone cataract surgery? No, cataract once removed does not develop again. This is because during cataract surgery, the natural lens is completely removed from your eye and thus there is no possibility of cataract forming again. I got cataract surgery done on my right eye 1 year ago, but the vision in my eye has dropped recently. My eye doctor says that he needs to clean my lens. What does he mean by that? So during cataract surgery, the artificial lens is placed on a thin membrane which is known as the posterior capsule. This posterior capsule is a transparent membrane, but with time it can turn opaque and this may cause decrease in vision. So when your doctor says that he needs to clean or polish your lens, what he means is that he is planning to get rid of this membrane. It does not require a surgical procedure. This membrane can be easily removed in the OPD with the help of laser. Can cataract lead to permanent blindness? No. In majority of the cases, no. Cataract does not cause permanent blindness. However, in some neglected cases of advanced cataract, your eye can develop glaucoma due to cataract, and if it is not treated as an emergency, this glaucoma may lead to blindness by causing irreversible damage to the nerve of your eye. And this is another very important reason why you should not wait for your cataract to mature and get it removed while it is still immature. So this is all for this video. In my next video, I will be answering your questions specifically on cataract surgery and intraocular lenses. If you have any questions, please post them in the comment section below. Till then, please like and share this video with your friends and family members if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel if this topic interests you. Thank you very much.